Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with you in spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, good morning.
Good morning, Father.
Today, of course, during all these weeks and years already, we pray in a special way for healing of those who suffer from COVID, that the whole world may be free from this pandemic. But also today, in a special way, by request of Pope Francis and of the Russian Bishops Conference, we pray for peace for the people of Ukraine. And at the beginning of this Eucharist, let us acknowledge our sins and ask the Lord for his forgiveness. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart, Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
You came to call sinners, Christ have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us, Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Pillar of iron. Fullness heart without love, then I am nothing at all. If I give away all that I possess, piece by piece, and if I even let them take my body to burn it, but I am without love, it will be to me no good whatever. Love is always patient and kind. It is never jealous. Love is never boastful or conceited. It is never rude or selfish. It does not take offense and is not resentful. Love takes no pleasure in other people's sins, but delights in the truth. It is always ready to excuse, to trust, to hope, and to endure whatever comes. Love does not come to an end. But in their gifts of prophecy, the time will come when they must fail. Or the gift of languages, it will not continue forever. And knowledge, for this too, the time will come when it must fail. For our knowledge is imperfect, and our prophesying is imperfect. But once perfection comes, all imperfect things will disappear. When I was a child, I used to talk like a child, and think like a child, and argue like a child. But now I am a man. All childish ways are put behind me. Now, we are seeing a dim reflection in a mirror, but then we shall be seeing face to face. The knowledge that I have now is imperfect, but then I shall know as I am known. In short, there are three things that last: faith, hope, and love. And the greatest of these is love. The word of the Lord.
They said, "This is Joseph's son, surely." There weren't many widows in Israel. I can assure you, in Elijah's day, when Hannah remained shut for 3 years and 6 months, and a great famine raged throughout the land, but Elijah was not sent to anyone of these. He was sent to a widow of Sarepta, a Sidonian town, and in the prophet Elisha's time, there were many lepers in Israel, but none of this was cured except the Syrian Canaan. When they brought this, everyone in the synagogue was in the red. They spread their feet and hustled him out of the town, and then took him up to the brow of the hill. The town was built on, intending to throw him down the cliff. But he slipped through the crowd and got away. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Lord Jesus Christ.
Because he doesn't proclaim
We ask God for courage to proclaim the gospel by living good lives, by speaking kindly, by acting justly. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
May the Lord give us open hearts that we may hear his voice in the people around us. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
We pray for people who find it hard to love, and for people who have known little love in their lives. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
May we allow love to be the motivation for all we do or say. May love lead us to God. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
We pray for all who have died. May they see the Lord face to face and know the love that has no end. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
We pray for the gift of peace for the people of Ukraine. We pray for humankind to be free from the pandemic. And in a moment of silence, we pray with all our personal intentions. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Lord, you are with us. You give us your love, your mercy, your grace, your kindness. For this we give you thanks and praise, now and forever.
Amen.
Yet we know that by testing us, you change our hearts, you prepare heaven for reconciliation. Even more, by your Spirit, you move human hearts, that enemies may speak to each other again, adversaries join hands, and people seek to meet together. By the working of your power comes about, Lord, that hatred is overcome by love, revenge gives way to forgiveness, and discord is changed to mutual respect. Therefore, as we give you ceaseless thanks to the choirs of heaven, we cry out to your majesty on earth, and without end we obtain.
We offer you We have a couple of brief special announcements. Firstly, thanks to all of us who donated last week's special collection from children in the mall for Philippines. We raised $5,000. Thank you for that. If anybody does have any items that could be useful that they would like to donate for the poor, the elderly, going to bring them in on Sunday mornings, leave them up over to the right, to the left of the altar over here behind where the ordinance is. Clothing, what matters is collected and quickly distributed to those in need. Next week, we'll discuss more about nominations for the parish council. We haven't made an official announcement yet, but many of our members are council members have left, and we are before an election under our charter anyway, so we'll be making announcements for that. If anyone who's interested in participating, you can be nominated, so you can ask me after Mass or wait for further announcements. Thank you.
Let us